What's going on, guys? Welcome to another color grading tutorial. And before we're going to continue doing our master series second episode, I'm just going to throw this in between, and it's actually going to be a very interesting tutorial for you guys too. I want to say first special thank you to Matthew Scott for allowing me to use his footage in our color grading tutorials. So thank you so much, Matthew. And in our tutorial today, I'm going to be turning this into that. So if you like what you see, stick around and I'm going to show you exactly how to achieve that look. And as my previous tutorials, I have no idea what I'm going to do. Everything is very unscripted. I'm just going to be going with the flow without actually knowing what's happening. So let's start our color grading. And the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to switch to the clip. And I'm going to change the gamma curve to red log film, just like this. And as far as the color space, I'm not really sure which red camera it was shot on. So I'm just going to keep it at red color 3 as it was in the default settings. Okay. And for now, let me actually see. Workspace, layout, reset. There we go. That way I can see what's going on. Okay, let's start color grading. So the first thing I'm going to do, like in my previous tutorials, I'm going to use a basic noise reduction. And a couple of people asked me how come I'm not using temporal noise reduction. Well, the reason is, just for the sake of tutorial, the temporal noise reduction is very, very powerful and strong. And whenever you apply it, it takes a lot of resources from your computer. So just for the tutorial, I'm only using very basic, that way it can get us more or less decent key. But, you know, if you have high-end project, obviously, you can use whatever it takes to reduce the noise. Neat video is great. If you don't have neat video, definitely temporal noise reduction is a very, very powerful stuff. Anyways, so my first note, I'm going to call it NR, noise reduction. And my second note, I'm going to introduce a little bit of color. Okay, very standard if you watch my previous tutorials. And I'm going to go in the key and I'm going to dial it down by half. Okay, 0.500 should be good. Let's check it out really quick. Before and after. Okay, that looks great. Let's bring RGB. And in my third note, let me actually label it as saturation. And my third note, I'm going to call it exposure. Okay. And the exposure note, I'm just going to bring shadows down. Okay. Just like that. And I'm going to bring highlights a little bit down as well. Actually, I'm going to keep shadows a little bit elevated. That way we have more stuff to play around with. Okay. So that looks great. Off the bat, the colors look very wonderful. I really like how she got a little bit of blush going on her cheeks. Very nice, very cinematic colors. And by the way, this tutorial, I'm not going to be using any LUTs. We're just going to grade as we go. Okay, so I'm going to create a new node, and I'm going to convert it to the layer node. And what I'm going to do in the layer node, actually, I'm going to turn everything monochrome. And I'm going to play a little bit with the look. Okay, like that looks great. And I'm going to use the blending mode overlay. Overlay is basically almost identical as a soft light, but overlay gives much stronger effect. Okay, so let's move things around. That way we have a little bit more space. Okay, that thing doesn't want to move. Okay, let's stay organized. All right, looks great. Now I'm going to go back into the node and I'm going to fix a few things. First of all, I want to have a very metallic feel to it. So I'm going to pull just like that. I want to have very interesting look of this particular grading. And I'm going to keep the shadows pretty much right over here. So let's check it out, the whole thing. Before and after. Before and after. Very nice. Now, I'm going to create a new node, and I'm going to call this one Look. Okay. Let me move this thing a little bit. Okay. And in our look, I'm just going to do a basic balance. Okay. Let me go right over here in the primaries bar. And in the primaries bar, I'm going to turn off Luma Mix. Okay. That way I can individually work with channels. And I'm just going to take off a little bit of greenish from the picture, because I think by default is a little bit too green. So if I'm going to go with the look, you can see actually what kind of effect we have. Okay, so that looks great. I can introduce a little bit of blue now. Okay, looks really good. And I can take away a little bit of red. All right, so I'm very happy with the look. It's very nice. Let's look at the full screen. Let's check it out, what we have going on. So let's see, before and after. Okay, that looks very, very nice. Now, I think the window is a little bit distracting. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create a new node and I'm gonna convert it into parallel. In here, I'm gonna call it window. Okay. And what I'm gonna do for the window, I'm just going to create a regular simple mask. Okay, just like that. And within that mask, I'm gonna qualify the Luma, which is technically the brightest of all, just like that. And I'm going to pull down a little bit on the highlights. That way we're just going to dim it a little bit. That way it's not so much in our face. Also, you can do a lot of different stuff with the window. Like, for example, you can add a little bit color if you wish, if it's a part of the look. But if you want to keep focus only on the talent, you can desaturate. That way we have more of her into the frame. Okay, so let's check it out before and after. So now we sort of dim down the picture. The next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to call this V for vignetting. I'm going to create a very simple vignette. Okay, just like that. And I'm going to bring down gamma. Okay, and then I'm going to invert it. Okay, and have a very nice feathering. All right, so let's take a look. Before and after. Before and after. We're sort of, at this point, we're actually relighting our shot. So let me move this. And let me create another node over here, that way we can see. Okay, so check it out, before and after. Let me go in the full screen so you guys can see better. And check out what we've done so far. So this was original, and this is after initial grading. Now, I want to take one step further, okay? And I want to create a more dramatic look for this. So again, we're in a parallel. I'm going to create another node, and I'm going to call this one Relighting, okay? And for the Relighting, I'm going to create a very simple custom mask, just like that. Very simple, very sloppy. And what I'm going to do, I'm actually going to give it a little bit of spike, okay, like that, a little bit of contrast. I'm going to introduce a little bit of feather, okay. Actually, I probably can do this thing even a little bit tighter, okay, like this. Like that looks very nice. Okay, like that looks good, and I can do actual feathering outside. The reason why I like to feather, I don't want to have any hard edges, and I want to make sure that everything in the color grading looks very, very natural. Okay, so let's actually give a little bit of gamma, okay? And let's check it out, before and after. Before and after. Huge difference, but I also see still a very hard trace of our adjustment. So I want to minimize that. Okay, and probably over here on her hair, I can cut it down just like this. All right, so let's see. That's our node. Let's check it out, what we've done. Okay. Very, very cool effect. So let's go back. Okay. And let's check out the whole entire shot. Before and after. Before and after. And now we actually have the illusion that the light falling from the window on her face. So we sort of made it more dramatic like that versus before it's all evenly lit. Okay. That looks very, very nice. And finally, just to kind of give it even more energy, I'm going to add film grain, okay, using film convert. Let me see. And I'm going to be using, let me make sure that we're using GPU. All right, film color, I'm going to turn it off. I want to use my favorite Super 16. I really, really love that look. Let's close this thing. And finally, I'm going to kill a little bit of highlights, just like this. Let's see. Okay. We're going to make it a little bit pasty. All right. Like that looks great. Let's check it out. Before and after. Before and after. Looks very, very nice. All right. So let's see. Let's check this out full screen. Actually, the amount of grain is a little bit too much. And I'm probably going to use 40. No, 40, too little. Let's go 50. Okay, 50 is appropriate. And finally, let's take a look at the whole thing. So let's see. Before and after. Okay, let's give it a nice playback. Let's check it out. So very interesting looking. We sort of created the effect that the light is falling from the car window. And I think it looks very, very cool. All right. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Next time, the second series of Master Color Grading. And make sure to subscribe and see you soon.